things change. And since I am working on myself since becoming my greatest version since 2014, I have been working on myself, on the connection that I have between me and the other part of me, to be able to navigate better into my daily life. And through meditation, through going into nature, through respecting myself, through loving myself at 100%, by doing what I truly desire each step, and allowing the process to take place, having faith into the unknown, facing fear, expanding my comfort zone, I am able to tell you that if you live in fear, that's what you're gonna attract. If you doubt of what I say, well, you're gonna be for a rude awakening, because I've been putting my word into action since 2014, and I've been through so many tough challenges, tough tests through all these years, and I always make it and standing tall. I'm here to tell you that by letting go of smoking drugs, smoking cigarettes, and let it go of alcohol and fast food, it helped me get the connection that I have. I allow the connection to flow fluidly, and this gives me the help that I need to know exactly where I need to stand at each and every step of the way of the day. I can see through signs, through intuition, by drinking alkaline water and detox my body, by taking protein shake, green shakes, and training my body properly, being in tune with my body daily, and by doing a sport, by moving my body, by going in radical action, not only by talking, but applying what I'm talking about in my daily life since 2014. By building a strong discipline, it's not happening in one day. It's gradually through so many transitions that you become more strong. By repetition, but putting your own twist to it, like not in a linear way, in a non-linear way of having a beautiful, healthy lifestyle. That's the way to go. So, like where I am right now, I know this place, but it was not planned that I came here, but I know that it feels right. I know that here the energy, it's proper to my own energy. I know my energy. And magic happens when you do that. The unknown is not always a place where you don't know. It's just the way you dress, the way you think, your purpose, and it's all combined. Yeah, so that's what I have to share with you. And with all the hurricanes that happen, definitely those who live in fear will suffer. It's not me. It's not me. I decide that. It's just that now with the new energy passing from the third dimension to the fifth dimension, there is a huge environment with the weather change. Like, Earth is changing, okay? Rapidly. And those who live in fear, those who live in drama, those who live in gossip, those who live in lower frequency, those who don't want to adapt to the new change, to move to the next level of the human race, will die, will suffer. They will not make it, because when you freak out, you are not able to live in magic and see the solution and see the beauty of life. So when the hurricane happens, if you don't live in your heart, if you don't put your heart into the driver's seat of your body, you don't gonna know where to go to be safe. You're not gonna be prepared mentally, physically, and emotionally to handle it. You're gonna break down. And maybe then, this breakdown will make that you're gonna let go of resistance of this change that we live right now on planet Earth, and then you're gonna live like you're supposed to be in the fifth dimension, and you're gonna apply the discipline of love, where only love lives. Tri-City, baby, that's the way to go. But it's sad that some people gonna need to suffer to realize that they need to change their lifestyle. I have an opportunity in 2014 because it was affecting my health. So I have an opportunity to say, okay, do I stay crumbled on the floor and in a pattern, in a linear way of living, of drama, of negativity, of a non-healthy lifestyle? Do I continue in this way where it's not good? I know, I can feel it, I'm not in the good path, and I'm really not happy. And I know that there is a better way of living than, you know, suffer in life. So I face fear and I start doing the freeline skate. And the freeline skate bring balance into my life, bring me to expand my comfort zone, to face fear, you know? Fear of a sport that I was not doing any sport at that time. It opened my eyes to a bigger picture of what can be life. And it bring me to so many areas I cannot count anymore. And it's only the beginning. Oh yes. So, those who live in their heart will know what to do, because their spirit, the higher self of them, will give you the insight, the direction, where to go. Through signs, through numbers, through a book, a movie, a video, a feeling. But it's always positive. If it's negative, it means that your life is probably in danger and you need truly to listen to that voice. Not in fear, but in precaution, you know, for your own safety. So, that's what I have to share with you, and I wish you the best. That's what happened when you put your heart into the driver's seat of your body and you have total faith. Even if you don't understand why it's happening, well, it will be revealed to you. Sometime it's not like right now, it's maybe tomorrow or in a week. But you need to have faith that it's the best for you. It's supposed to happen. And you don't need to understand why. Peace. Chicken Killip style, baby.